A fundamental aspect of xGenerative design is generating and managing data through lists. These lists can quickly become complex structures. In order to efficiently work with them, it's important to understand the concept of list dimension and how to manipulate them. This video will show you how to navigate list dimensions within your xGenerative models. In xGenerative design, a single node represents an operation on data. Input and outputs of each node represent a collection of data and can be of various dimensions. Dimension 0 is a single item. Dimension 1 is a list. Dimension 2 is an array. Dimension 3 can be represented like this, etc. A structure is composed of a root, another set of items, and atomic elements, represented like this in the user interface, or displayed in an array in the case of two-dimensional lists. You can display the structure size on the flows using this setting in xGenerative design. This symbol represents a list of 24 elements with a structure of 2 by 4 by 3. An operation executes an operator that works on a specific dimension of data. The operator intersect, for example, works on two elements of dimension 0, such as a plane and a curve to compute an intersection point. Therefore, the operation manages input to feed the operator the best way possible. For example, intersecting two lists of the same size will compute a list of intersections between the first element of the first list and the second element of the second list, and put the results in the list. If one input is a singleton, the output will be a list of intersections of every element with this singleton. If the two inputs are a list of different size and not a singleton, no match can be found and the operation returns an error. In other words, input structures must have the same number of items or be singleton. But how can we compute an intersection of two lines and three planes? We can use the combine operation for this. It will create structures to operate every element of the first list with every element of the second list. And here is the structure of the result. Let's see how to create a grid of 2 by 3 by 4 cubes. To create the cube, start by a planar square, defined by two points. One at coordinate 10 mm on x and 10 mm on y, the other point will be the origin of the model. The plane of the square is the xy plane. Use the fill command to create a surface, then thickness to generate a cube as a volume. Next, display the graph and create a grid on the xy plane. This is a 2x3 grid of points with a spacing of 10 mm. The output is an array of 2x3 as expected. Now let's create a list of 4 points along the z-axis with the same spacing of 10 mm. If we try to translate the 2D grid along these 4 points, the operation fails because the two input structures are not compatible. No match can be found in this case. But with a deepen operation on the first input, the structures become compatible, so let's insert a deepen operation and see the new result. Now we have a 3D grid of points that can be used to create a list of cubes. Next, we will translate the initial cube along the 3D grid of points. In fact, the rule of compatibility is a little more complex for structures of different depths, but always try to find the best possible match. Dimension is handy to manipulate structured data. For example, if you use getItems to get the first elements of the structure, this node by default will operate on the lowest level of the list structure, defined as dimension 1, and therefore it returns this result. If you set dimension 2, the node returns the first element on one level above in the structure. If you set dimension 3, the node works at the third level of the list structure from the bottom, which is the same as if you set the dimension to minus 1 because minus 1 by convention designates the root level. In other words, setting the dimension dictates at which level the operation is performed. Counting up from the bottom of the structure, on minus 1 is the root level. Every list of any dimension can always be flattened into a different structure. To flatten a list, use the flatten node. The flatten operator works by default at the root level of minus 1. On level 2, the flatten will only occur from the second level. To produce this simple structure, you can start by creating a sequence of two real numbers, 1 and 2, then use the build list node that works by default on terminal nodes, or dimension 0. Items are taken on the lowest level to create lists aggregated under a root level. If you change the dimension setting to 1 on both entries, the list is now created from the upper level of the structure, which is the same as if you set it to minus 1 because in this case, the input structures have only two levels. This animation shows how lists are built from the upper level. If input structures have different depth, Building lists from the top down can produce an unbalanced result, with items at different levels, which is not recommended. This is why it's always safer, when possible, to use a positive value as a dimension. For example, 1, on the previous example, would produce this structure. In short, dimension increases the capacity of pattern design. The rule to remember is that a node operates on corresponding elements one by one, or one element against all the others. But when working with lists whose sizes do not match, you can make them match by using combine, deepen, flatten, group, and the fit nodes. And finally, remember, whenever possible, to use positive values to control the dimension of lists.